Hi everyone, Lisa Haven here. Well, information that we have been waiting on has finally come out, and that is the information found on Anthony Weiner's laptop. It has officially been released to Judicial Watch, who they're getting parts of it, not all of it. A lot of it has been, some of it's redacted, some of it's still classified, but they were finally able to get their hands on some of that tangible information. Now, if you don't know who Anthony Weiner is, he's the disgraceful congressman who admitted and pleaded guilty to sending obscured and, you know, very bad images to a minor. Very ugly in the inside, if you ask me. Very ugly heart. But anyway, that is whose information has finally been leaked to given to Judicial Watch via the Freedom of Information Act. And Judicial Watch took them to court and like sued them for not giving part of that information. And they're finally getting their hands on some of those files. But let me take you straight to the source, because I think ding dong, the witch is going down, if you get my drift. But check out this report on Judicial Watch. This is titled Judicial Watch Official Statement on the Department Release of Huma Abedin's Government Documents on Weiner's Laptop. Now, Tom Fitton is the president, and this is what he had to say, and I'm just going to quote him exactly. This is a major victory. After years of hard work in federal court, Judicial Watch has forced the State Department to finally allow Americans to see these public documents. It will be in keeping with our past experience that Abedin's emails on Weiner's laptop will include classified and other sensitive materials, that these government documents were on Anthony Weiner's laptop dramatically illustrates the need for Justice Department to finally do some real serious investigation of Hillary Clinton and Huma Abedin's obvious violations to the law. Now, in accordance with a court, now this is what the report goes on to say, in accordance with a court-ordered production of documents, a State Department court filing states approximately 2,800 work-related documents are among the documents provided by the FBI. The State Department told the court to expect a complete review of it and production of the FBI records by December 31st. And that's where we're at right now. Now, the documents, as you know, were requested by Judicial Watch because they threatened to sue them and all of that. So I'm going to skip that section. But Abedin, if you don't know who she was, she is the former Secretary of State for Hillary, Rodham. Yes, I said Rodham on purpose, Rodham, whatever, Clinton there. But she was her the former Secretary of State for Hillary Clinton's Deputy Chief of Staff. And the information contained on some of those files were reportedly backups of Hillary's emails. But here's another report on Judicial Watch, and this is just new Clinton emails on Weiner's laptop. But that kind of gets into some similar information. I'm going to take you to one last report. This is on USA Today, and it's in regards to the same stuff, but State Department releases classified emails from Clinton aide Huma Abedin found on Anthony Weiner's laptop. Now, the report details some of the corruption found on Hillary Clinton's emails that were linked. Now, what I'm going to show you now is just some of the information found on her emails, if you will. A November 2010 email was partially redacted due to classified and confidential information. It detailed a planned call between Clinton and Saudi foreign minister there when then Secretary of State Clinton would warn Al-Fazl, and excuse the pronouncing on that, and WikiLeaks planning to release some of the sensitive documents. That same month, WikiLeaks came out and released the Cablegate. A second email was also found in 2010 that mentions talks with United Arab Emirates foreign minister, and that had classified information. Another, again, in November 2011, it was redacted and marked confidential. And also another one here, there was a subject line in the emails that read Egyptian MFA on Hamas PLO talks. Again, these are your Palestinian talks, confidential information. Now, that report on USA Today, which I was shocked they actually had that information on there, but it gets into some of the information and classified information that has thus far been shared by Hillary Rodham Clinton. But some of the messages are absolutely linked to Weiner's laptop. So, What I say is, let's finally get the ball rolling on this investigation. And they need to start with some of the stuff obviously found on Weiner's laptop. According to Judicial Watch, that's exactly what needs to happen. And I agree 100%. Not to mention all the corruption on her uranium one. I mean, she's got a pile that reaches the sky, but she's a big cookie to crumble, and I hope she crumbles soon. Anyhow, I wanted to bring you all the latest updates on that. As I get information, I'll keep you up to date. Anyhow, don't forget to check out my partner at GetTheTea.com. Remember, he has all kinds of amazing organic, GMO-free, products there. Everything from colostrum to your mother's milk to vitamin C, and he's got liquid forms and also non-liquid forms. So make sure you check out all of that. Anyhow, thanks again for tuning in. I'm Lisa Haven, signing out.